Welcome to the video lecture series in History, Class 12th. Today we'll discuss about third chapter, which deals with kinship, caste and class in early societies between 600 BCE to 600 CE. In this chapter, we'll deal with four subtopics. Those are Mahabharata, a historical resource, kinship and marriage, social differences, resources and status. Today we will discuss about social differences. Social differences gives an insight into meaning of social differences, classification based on jatis and shrenis or guilds, and between varna system and jatis. It also deals with integration versus subordination, whether chandalas accepted the life of degradation prescribed in the shastras, integration within the framework of caste was often a complicated process, and difference between the Buddhist theory of social contract and Brahmanical view of society derived from the Purush Sukta. Now, what does social difference mean? It is a set of hierarchically ordered social categories in which Brahmanas were ranked first, followed by Kshatriyas, Vaishyas and Shudras respectively. It is laid down in Dharam Shastras and Dharam Sutras. Brahmanas call it a divine order, and to justify their claim, Brahmanas often cited a verse or mantra from Rig Veda known as Purush Sukta. The Dharam Shastras and Dharam Sutras prescribed rules about the ideal occupation of these social categories. According to these rules, Brahmanas were expected to teach, preach, perform sacrifices and give and receive gifts. Kshatriyas were expected to engage in warfare, protect people, administer justice, study Vedas, get sacrifices performed and give gifts. Vaishyas were expected to engage in agriculture, pastoralism and trade, and Shudras were expected to serve the above three. Those are Brahmanas, Kshatriyas and Vaishyas. Now, what were these classifications based on jatis and guilds or shrenis? As we can see here, fourfold Varna system was based on birth. Jatis were also based on birth, and guilds were those jatis having common occupation. In Varnashram system, Varnas were four in number. Those were Brahmanas, Kshatriyas, Vaishyas and Shudras. Whereas, jatis were many in number. Those who did not easily fit into fourfold Varna system, they were incorporated in jatis. And these were the new groups the Brahmanical authorities came across, like Suvarnkar or Goldsmith. Now, what is integration versus subordination? As we can see here, in case of Malechas, who as an example of integration we will take, and Chandalas as example of subordination. Malechas were not influenced by Brahmanical ideas. So, Sanskrit text described them as odd and uncivilized. The Brahmanas considered some people as totally outside the system. These people were called untouchables. These untouchables were kept away from certain activities which were considered as sacred and pure. Those who considered themselves pure, they avoided taking food from untouchables. Example of integration is Nishada tribe, to which Eklavya belonged, and example of subordination is Chandalas. Integration with Brahmanical system was tried through sharing of ideas and beliefs, as in the case of marriage between Hidimba and Bhim. Some activities were considered polluting, like handling corpses and dead animals, and those who performed such tasks were called Chandalas. So, untouchables based on the theory of purity and Chandalas based on the theory of pollution. This developed a sharper social divide. Manusmriti laid down the duties of the Chandalas, and Chinese pilgrims like Fahian and Hyunsang, they wrote about their miserable life. But the big question arises, whether Chandalas accepted the life of degradation prescribed in the Shastras? Sometimes non-Brahmanical texts, they describe about the acceptance of the life of degradation by Chandalas as prescribed in the Shastras. But occasionally there are hints of resistance and rebellion too, as in the story from Matanga Jatak, where the Bodhisat is the Buddha in the previous birth, is identified as Chandala. Now comes, integration within the framework of caste was often a complicated process. This was often a complicated process, as is evident from the following examples. First example, according to Dharam Shastras and Dharam Sutras, only Kshatriyas could be kings, but several important ruling dynasties originated from other Varnas. Example is Maurya dynasty, whom Brahmanical texts describe as of low origin. So, anybody who has courage to gain power and resource can gain political power and rarely depended on birth as a Kshatriya. Second example is of the Shakas, as we can see in the map where they ruled. The Shakas came from Central Asia and they were integrated within the framework of caste system by calling Malechas or fallen Kshatriyas by the Brahmanas. Third example is of the famous ruler of Satvahana dynasty, as we can see in the map again where they ruled. The ruler is Gautamiputta Sri Satakarni, who claimed to be a unique Brahmana and destroyer of the pride of Kshatriyas. He also claimed to have ensured that there was no intermarriage among members of the four Varnas, but at the same time, he who called himself unique Brahmana, he himself entered into a marriage alliance with the king of Shak ruler Rudradaman. The Shakas were called the fallen Kshatriyas. Fourth example is again of the Satvahanas, who claimed to be Brahmanas, and as Brahmanas they should teach and preach, but they were rulers, which was the occupation of the Kshatriyas. They also practiced endogamy. Endogamy means marrying within the Gotra, instead of exogamy, that is marriage outside the Gotra, which was recommended in the Brahmanical texts. So, integration within the framework of caste was often a complicated process. Now, what is the difference between the Buddhist theory of social contract and Brahmanical view of society derived from the Purush Sukta? According to Purush Sukta mantra or hymn in the Rig Veda, the four Varnas, namely Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya and Shudra. They were born from the sacrifice of Purush, Purush the primeval man. The social status of all these four Varnas depended upon their birth. Whereas, according to social contract theory of the Buddhist, initially all beings lived in an idyllic state of peace, taking from nature only what they needed for each meal. But gradually, human beings became greedy and manipulative, and thus social and economic differences were created. But these differences were neither natural nor permanent and could only change in future. The social contract theory of Buddhism rejected social status based on birth. So, in this, we discussed about number one, meaning of social differences, number two, classification based on jatis and shrenis or guilds, and between Varna system and jatis. We also discussed about integration versus subordination and whether chandalas accepted the life of degradation prescribed in the shastras. We discussed about integration within the framework of caste was often a complicated process, and difference between the Buddhist theory of social contract and Brahmanical view of society derived from the Purush Sukta.